By the spring of 1863, only the Confederate stronghold of Vicksburg, Mississippi, stood in the way of the Union seizing control of the entire Mississippi River. In May 1863, the Union Army of the Tennessee, commanded by General Ulysses S. Grant, launched a campaign across southern Mississippi and Arkansas in an attempt to take Vicksburg. Grant's forces launched attacks that captured the Mississippi capital of Jackson and pushed Confederate forces to retreat to Vicksburg. The rebels, under the command of Lieutenant General John Pemberton, heavily fortified the city with trenches, forts, and ramparts in preparation for an imminent Union attack. On May 19th, Grant launched an unsuccessful assault on the city and was repulsed after suffering heavy casualties. Knowing Confederate food stores and other supplies were running dangerously low, Grant decided to wait the rebels out and laid siege to the city instead of attempting further attacks. For over 6 weeks, Union artillery and gunboats along the Mississippi River shelled the city, waging war against civilians as well as the Confederate military garrison. By late June, civilians in Vicksburg were living in small, cramped caves they had dug into the ground along the hillside. Outside the city, citizens were eating leather belts and shoes to survive, as food and supplies within the city were almost gone. Union soldiers began calling Vicksburg Prairie Dog Village because its citizens lived underground. On July 4th of 1863, the same day that Lee began his retreat from Gettysburg, the Confederates surrendered the city of Vicksburg to Ulysses S. Grant and the Army of the Tennessee. The last rebel stronghold of the Mississippi had fallen. By seizing Vicksburg, the Union had cut the Confederacy in two. The states of Arkansas, Texas, and Louisiana were sealed off from the rest of the Confederacy, and the Union had complete control of the Mississippi River.